like the token block, the manual block, and some of the telegraph tokenless block. So the next thing I want to introduce that is that MRT has the longest automatic railways in the world among all the urban metro systems. So first let me introduce a concept, the degrees of automation. It is divided into 4 degrees. The highest one is level 4, which is trains are capable of operating automatically at all times. And for the level 3, trains run from stations to stations automatically, but sometimes a driver is needed for like handling of emergency situations and things like that. And for the level 2, it is the lowest level of automation. And the driver is in charge of a lot more things, like the doors and the emergency situations, and sometimes you need to the driver's intervention during the track. And level 1, there's no level 1 because level 1 is completely manual. And all the MRT lines except the green line and red line are level 4 automation, and the green line and the red line are classified as level 3. So here are some of the progress we've made throughout the year. In 2013, we started to place the sleepers, the wooden sleepers that are easily rotten during the years. And this project is completed in December 2016. And we're adding new signaling systems and electricity. And besides, we're extending our lines. And from in 2025, we're planning to add 3 new stations to the circle loop. And so, in conclusion, I think that despite the fact that Singapore MRT is not as new as the Hangzhou system and doesn't have a long history like London Tube, but I think that we're still operating pretty well compared to our previous situation, and basically suits the need of our Singaporean citizens. And so I believe that MRT will have a better future. And now this is the end of our little forum, and we're open to questions. All right. For example, the Beijing metro system, the older stations usually suffer from their balance because their station is designed improperly. So that in order to keep the air conditioners going on, you need to turn the air con on for like 24 hours a day. But in the lately constructed Beijing metro stations, they changed the design so that the metro station has a little curb near the entrance so that the temperature can be kept relatively cool without so much using of the aircon. So that is one of the Hong Kong metro ways advantage, significant advantage compared to others.
And the net profit is just a part of the
steps.
To show that the RTR is operating method well. By the company, so it's like Singapore. MRT can also give you a higher price, but you wouldn't like to do that. If they give you a higher price, then I think more people will choose to take bus.
So that is only one way of comparing. It doesn't show the whole picture, but it did show something, like what I previously answered in Eric's question.
Hasn't gone capitalist, it will be more than a